got a special guest in the house. Please give a warm welcome to our good friend. It is Joe Snell. Morning, Joe.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm doing great.
How do you pronounce your last name?
Snell.
Snell?
Yeah.
What, does it have any meaning? Like where did it come from?
It
is it short?
From Germany. It's von Schnell. It's like quick.
Ah.
Yeah.
So wait, is it like Snell or is it like Snellagering?
No, just von Schnell. It's Snell. They changed it when they came to the States.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, welcome to the show, Joe.
Thank you.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. Doing great.
So you're visiting. This is the second time you being in Erbil.
Second time I visit. Yeah, I'm here for 2 weeks.
What month were you here the first time you were here?
June, July, 2019.
Summer. Why?
Summer.
That's the worst time.
We try to tell people, bro, if you're going to visit us in our wonderful city, please come when the weather is nice. It's like when your house is messy and you don't want people to come, you tell them, hey, can you come in an hour? But like, I don't know why. Joe, why do you come when the weather is hot?
I just like the weather. It's hot. Got to get the tan.
So you're more of a hot guy than instead of a cold guy?
100%. Yeah.
So where are you from originally?
I'm from Indiana.
Okay, that makes sense. You just want to like experience the Iraqi sun.
Yeah, I think so.
And no electricity as well in the same time.
Yeah, exactly.
A really great combination, you know?
Yeah.
So Joe, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where have you lived besides Indiana? What did you study? What's going on with you? How'd you end up being Joe?
Here. Yeah, I grew up in Indiana, and then I studied for a year in Chicago, and then I transferred to Los Angeles, and then I studied and worked out there in the entertainment industry for about 8.5 years, and then I moved to Texas, and I was there for about 3 years, and then I went to Chicago again, and now I'm in D.C.
If you know, like, if you understood, like, the U.S. geography, you would notice that he did, like, a whole circle.
That's right.
You started from the Middle East, and then you went west, and then you went south, and then you went back to the Middle East. Mid-East.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And why did you do that?
Schooling, jobs, followed some of the work.
So are you, like, the kind of guy that likes to travel a lot?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, it's fun.
So you better be careful with your passport, though, because, you know, if you're going to travel a lot, you don't want to lose that.
You don't want to lose it.
No, you don't want to. Right, no. I'm joking that end because he lost his passport, but he found it.
Oh, they found it last night. Yeah. Oh, my God.
That's like the scariest feeling ever.
Can you imagine?
Especially being in a different country and losing your passport.
Yeah.
It's pretty scary.
Yeah.
Okay, so, Joe, you mentioned a lot of different places, and you said you worked in the entertainment industry.
Yeah, that's right.
What did you do exactly in the entertainment industry?
Yeah, so I studied film and business law for my undergrad, and then I worked at, there's a place called Creative Artists Agency. It's a talent agency out there. I was also at Fox Sports. And if you've seen Entourage, it covers a talent agency, so that's kind of what it is.
Guys look for talent?
Well, yeah, it represents writers, directors, actors, like other talents as well, finding them opportunities and then looking for like up and coming talents to represent as well.
AM, did you hear that? He's got the hookup in Hollywood.
All right.
No.
You can hook us up, me and Noor.
Do you know about the WASTA system?
I do know about the WASTA system.
So you need to start implementing it, son. Get us to Hollywood. that sounds like a really exciting. But where? So in Los Angeles or where in California?
Yeah, it was in Los Angeles.
How was that experience?
I liked it a lot. It was just, so I was working out there, and it was October 2016, and I saw a bit about what was going on here with family and friends, and I wanted to help the community a bit more. So that's when I transitioned into journalism. So then I went to Texas and I slept on my sister's couch and I got a local news job reporting. And I've been doing that ever since.
So now you're a journalist.
Yeah.
What do you like to cover? Because M also likes to kind of write sometimes. Didn't you start first wanting to do journalism?
Not really. I was literally just covering up like news because, we needed some updates for our website. But I think it's so interesting. You transitioned from doing entertainment to journalism.
Yeah.
I guess they are connected in
but
different in the same time. So, what was your main reason for transitioning?
Well, with the studies in Los Angeles and the work there, it's all about storytelling. Journalism is all about storytelling too. So you use a lot of the same skills. I think a big reason why I did it is I think there are a lot of stories coming out of certain places that are like all pretty negative and like death, destruction, blah blah blah. But there are a lot of good stories happening that a lot of people don't know about. So those needed to be covered.
Journalism is very different when you look at like journalists from Europe compared to journalism in America. And in America, it is that what you said, that a lot of just let's go for the headlines of death and destruction,
clickbait,
and not actual like cool things that are happening. For example, in the Middle East. So what do you like to write about now? Like, what's your topics that interest you?
Rebuilding efforts. I think all stories about, I think they're really fascinating individuals that need attention. Like one story I just did somewhat recently was Ahlan Simsim, the new Sesame Street show that was put out. But we did it from, a lot of people were interviewing the executive producers and like other people. The way I approached it was interviewing, they premiered it at a refugee camp in Syria. So getting comments from some of the kids that first watched it was pretty fun.
That sounds exciting.
Yeah.
Like, do you enjoy your job? Do you enjoy doing this?
Or
do you
feel like it? Yeah, absolutely.
If you weren't a journalist, what job would you do then?
What job would I be? A farmer in Texas or Montana or something like that.
Why do you say that?
I don't know. I like that lifestyle. I love Texas. I consider Texas home. It's a lifestyle.
Do you like farming games?
Farming games? No, it's a little bit different.
You should test it for see, make sure if you like that lifestyle or not.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
No, I don't think it's the same thing. But so how did you end up here? Why Erbil?
I have some family and friends here that I was visiting, and I mean, I love this area. It's fun.
Oh, you have some family here. So you're originally from?
My mom grew up in Baghdad, and then she went to Greece for a few years, and then she went to the States. But yeah, she grew up in Baghdad.
Okay, so you got some kind of a Middle Eastern connection.
Yeah.
The world is so big, though. Like, you could be doing your interests in South America or in Asia or in Africa. Like, there's a lot of interesting places around this world that, you know, the typical American journalism has not covered.
Yeah.
So what you mentioned a little bit, but can you give us more? Why are you so fascinated with the Middle East and writing articles about the Middle East?
Well, there were a lot of stories growing up I would hear about on, but they would only exist on Facebook comments and Twitter and things like that, or phone calls between family and friends. I didn't see a lot of these stories being covered, and I thought it was important to get them out. And it was a good opportunity because I had access to like a lot of these different stories.
And so now you work for who?
I work for Al Monitor.
That's a big company. I mean, it looks big for us here, so that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, it's a good one. I love this audience you guys have around you.
Yeah, we have a lot of people listening to us.
200 people are around.
Yeah, we have a lot of people listening to us here. So Joe, how has it been now, you know, working like full-time journalism like the way you are that covers the Middle East?
Oh, I love it. I love it. And so my master's studies were in journalism. So I acquired the skills, and then I got the job at Al Monitor. It's been great.
You need to write an article about Babylon FM. Don't you agree, Am?
Shameless plug.
Yes. I
wonder what would be the title. It would be...
I don't know. I'm trying to like think of something interesting that we do here.
The alarm clock.
Radio faces. Why are they so ugly?
I like that.
Yeah, that would make the most sense. But yeah. I was going to ask you, is it hard communicating, coming to the Middle East? Like, do you know how to speak Arabic?
Not very well, no. And that's my issue.
So what do you do then to get by that?
I have translators, but we spoke a bit about it. It's important to know the language when you come to these places. So it's about picking it up.
Yeah, definitely. It's possible. It's not like something hard.
Yeah.
I mean, if we can just learn language.
Noor, don't even say that. Hold on. Noor is saying it's not something hard. You've been here for how many years?
Here's the thing, Joe. I went to Dubai last in December.
Oh. Yeah.
Because, you know, in December, me and my wife
went
to Dubai.
By the way, he mentions this like every single day. Like, you have to hear about this every day.
I went to Dubai. I took a plane and I went to Dubai.
You could probably finish the story, couldn't you?
Yeah. Everybody listening can finish the story.
I went to Dubai in December.
Yeah.
So it was pretty cool. I took a plane to Dubai, of course.
Yeah.
And there, like, I practiced my Arabic. And it was helpful. Like, it wasn't that hard compared to the Arabic that I used, you know, here to there. Like, so
no, you really don't have to put our guests through this. You know that.
So I want to hear this. It sounds good.
Yeah. So there's a story in the end. You know, it's basically I went to Dubai.
Oh, that's it. Okay, never mind.
This is a story
never
that he repeats every single day.
I could have finished that story.
Anywho, Joe, it's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
Tell us about what's different in terms of what you see here, the way society works. Like, what fascinates you in terms of how things are here?
It fascinates me, and I think a lot of my like friends back home, I show them like pictures and videos of the city, walking through the city, talking to people, and they're surprised at how like modern it is. I think that goes back to the media thing too. I think like a view that's shown here is it's not as modern as it is, and you come here and it's completely different perception.
Yeah, we definitely need more positive public relations. So if you could like make us look good in American media, then maybe our passport strength would be a lot better. You know what I'm saying?
All right, all right, all right.
Just don't lose it.
No, just don't lose it. I don't know if you know, but the Iraqi passport is the third worst passport in the world. So, like, we're hoping you guys, the media's out there in Europe and America, you could say, hey, people from Iraq, they are good people.
Oh, yeah, all the influence we have. We'll just make a call.
Yes. Yeah, that's what we need. We need a campaign. Let's have, like, all these celebrities, right, posting stories and posts about, hey, let's change the Iraqi passport conditions. And then maybe there'll be a big campaign. We should start with Kim Kardashian. She's got a little Middle Eastern background.
Yeah, just give her a call.
And she's a lawyer. She has some connections with the government right now.
It's enough.
She sounds like a good person to start with.
It's enough of us not being able to travel whenever we want. Iraqi passport holders.
You don't understand the struggle of having an Iraqi passport. I guess, like, it's literally one of the hardest things.
It is. It definitely is. Joe, let's talk about in terms of just like leisure. You showed us you have a dog.
I do have a dog.
What's his name?
His name is Buddy.
And he weighs more than you, right?
No, he doesn't. He's 140, though. He's pretty big.
He's almost as big as you.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's a beautiful dog.
He
but
is.
How, like, this thing is like almost like a mini donkey. Like, that's how big this thing is. How did you find him?
Yeah, I got him in Texas. He was at a small little shelter out there. And I was looking for, so he's a Bernese mountain dog mixed with a Great Pyrenees. So it's really friendly, like good with kids and stuff like that. So, yeah. Worked out.
The cutest dogs. Do they get any bigger though? You showed us the picture. He was.
He won't get any bigger now. Thank God.
How do you shower this dog?
How do I shower him?
Yeah, because it's
with a miracle. There's this huge bin. It's a huge like gray bin that I have to put him in every month.
And how long does it take for you to usually shower the dog?
Oh, the showering part is the easy part. The hard part is drying him. So that takes like washing him takes a solid like 15-20 minutes, but drying him takes like a few hours.
Why do you have to dry him? If he's living in Texas, why can't you just let him chill?
Well, he's in D.C. with me now.
Oh, so you don't want to get him sick?
Yeah.
Wait, your dog takes 10, 15 minutes?
Well, to like wash, but then to dry takes a long time.
Yeah, that's a lot faster. I'm just 2 minutes in the shower. I
have
two,
hair, and it's way faster than that. But they don't. they should shower every month, right?
They should shower, like, he showers between every 2 weeks to every, like, 3 weeks to month. Yeah.
It is a lot of work, but it's a really cute dog, so it's worth it.
You mentioned a little bit of Fox Sports background. Are you interested in sports?
I love sports, yeah.
What do you watch?
Basketball, American football. I'm getting into soccer now or football now, but, yeah, those two are the big ones.
So with the basketball, who's your team?
Bulls, Chicago Bulls.
You like Chicago Bulls?
Yeah.
What do you think about that documentary that came, The Last Dance? How amazing was that?
Oh,
was it done?
That was awesome, yeah. I can't wait to see what the next one they come out with.
Do you think they're going to come out with something else?
Maybe a Kobe one? We'll see.
Yeah. It's really beautiful watching some of these documentaries. And I think I would love to see more of these kind of documentaries maybe be done from here where, like, you tell a story.
That'd be great.
Like,
what about the Babylon Media?
The Babylon Media story, yes.
Story.
I think it would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so then what do you do for fun when you're not working, when you're not washing your dog?
It's washing my dog takes up a lot of the time. I play sports, and I read a lot, and I spend time with friends.
What do you like to read?
I read a lot of news.
Oh, okay.
For better or for worse, and then a lot of like history books, too. I love like reading about U.S. presidents as well, and then just history about the region.
Let's talk about, like, you liked reading the news and stuff like that. Yeah. You see how the Middle East is currently at the moment. Just, like, a lot of weird things happening here and there.
Yeah.
What do you, like, let's say from 1 to 10, what is your optimism level for the Middle East 5 years from now? Or let's say in the year 2025, 4 years from now.
Optimism,
what is your level of optimism that things are going to be good here?
Well, it's, what do you mean good?
Like, no war, not people running away, no terrorism, and good economy.
Yeah. Well, I think that a lot of that stuff is just always going to be around. It's just like the level of where it's going to be around because it's everywhere. But I'm optimistic. I think things are trending in the right direction.
Give us a number from 1 to 10.
Oh, my gosh. 7.
That's great optimism, man. That means we're still going to have jobs.
Yes. I also, like, similar to that question, what would you say from 1 of 10, how accurate is the media representation of Iraq?
What country are we talking? Just in general
from
of the world or from where I'm from? Where I'm from, probably like a 3.
Damn.
That's really bad.
This is why, again, this goes back to why we have a bad passport. It's because of
it's
this.
Our
Hashtag change the passport.
Change the strength of the passport.
Yeah.
I know we talk a lot about it, but it's a really big thing. Like, people want to have the opportunity to vacation whenever they want, wherever they like.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, they can't, especially when we have the hot weather that we have here.
Yeah.
We want to escape for a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
And it just feels good to go somewhere and just not be burning.
Where do most people here vacation?
Well, because the passport is the way it is, it's mostly Turkey.
Okay.
And of course, I mean, if you have, like, you do like me, you go to Dubai. I went to Dubai in December. I don't know if I told you, but go to Dubai.
Tell us the story about Dubai.
Well, Dubai, you know, when I went and landed in Dubai, it was just, like, really beautiful because they have, you know, they have beautiful beaches there, right? Yeah. So, like, they thought of, like, everything. Like, it's really amazing. So, you can, for example, go, like, riding on, like, a boat in the day, and then you could go to the mall and, like, go down in the snow, for example, these artificial snows that they've created.
Yeah.
There's just a lot of things. You can ride a camel, because Dubai is really cool.
Yeah.
I went to Dubai. Anyways, let's not talk about Dubai, Joe. Sorry, I lost my mind. How long are you staying here for?
I leave on Saturday. A couple more days. I've been here for 2 weeks.
What did you learn in these 2 weeks?
What did I learn in 2 weeks? I met a lot of new great people, if that helps.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm starting to like it more and more.
Your favorite food here?
Favorite food?
Yes.
I've had so much beef kebab, but there are, like, different kebab places that I like a lot. But yeah, beef kebab.
The kebabs here.
Good choice.
Yeah.
The meat here, just, you can't compare it to anywhere else in the world.
No.
It's really something special. Like, when you feel that gain of weight that you're having, you do it with a passion. Joe, make sure you weigh a lot more when you have left before you...
I'll weigh myself.
I want to make sure. Yeah, I want to make sure that we have fed you properly.
Yeah.
Well, we're looking forward to see lots of your articles, but how can we be, like, in touch with you? How can we see your work? What do we just type Joe Snell?
You look up Al Monitor. That's an important one. And then just follow me on some of my social media things.
What do they type?
Twitter is JoeSnell03, and then Instagram is JoeSnellReports.
There you have it. Catch up with him. And maybe if you have some interesting idea for stories, you guys, let's start influencing these Western journalists. Text them through Twitter or through ever.
Yeah.
Just type it and then see if you can get in touch with him. I hope you had the opportunity to have fun here, Joe, because to be honest with you, whenever we have visitors here, we want them to, like, have a good impression of the city, not just come and just eat kebabs all day. Even though that's a good thing. Like, eating kebabs all day is a good thing.
Yeah.
But, like, I hope you had fun.
Did you
have fun?
What is your guys' favorite part of the city?
I mean, to be honest with you, I'm the kind of guy that likes oxygen.
All right.
I like going to the park because that's the highest concentration of oxygen. I love going to the Samu Park and just walking around.
Yeah, I went there a few times this week.
Yeah.
It's fun.
It really is. I don't know, Em. I don't know what you like to do.
I agree. The same thing. The park.
Yeah.
Anywhere where there's, like, something green. Yeah. You can go and smell fresh oxygen.
It has to involve oxygen and food, and the park has those two things, and that's the only thing I care
about.
And it's free. You know what I'm saying? During these difficult times.
Yeah.
Joe, thank you so much. Any last words before we say goodbye to you?
No, thank you guys. Appreciate it.
Well, good luck with everything. Hopefully, we'll get to see you more often. Type Joe Snell right now on Twitter so you can be in touch with him, and then pitch in some ideas, you guys. He's open for writing ideas. So if you have any idea about a great story to write about, something that's positive, that can make Erbil, the Kurdistan region, and Iraq look good, then go ahead, send it to him right there. Joe, thank you so much, and good luck with everything.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
All right.